Hello students, in this class I am going to discuss about immune response in multicellular organisms. Basically, the immune response is a specific reactivity induced in a host by an antigenic stimulus is known as immune response. It is the basic protection against invading multicellular organisms, and it may lead to consequences which may be either beneficial, indifferent, or injurious. The immune response can be of two types. One is the humoral mediated immunity, and another one is cell mediated immunity. Usually, they are developed together, but either may be predominant, exclusive, or sometime act together, or sometime in opposite orientation. Basically, the humoral mediated immunity is an antibody production method, and these antibodies are produced from plasma cells present in the blood and other body fluid. These body fluids are known as humoral body fluid, and it provides defense against most bacterial pathogens and viruses. And they are also participate in pathogenesis of type 1, 2, and 3 hypersensitivity reaction and autoimmune disorders. The cell-mediated immunity is the specific immune response that doesn't involve antibody, and it protects against fungi, viruses, and facultative intercellular bacterial pathogens for the rejection of homografts and graft versus host reactions. It provides immunological surveillance and immunity against cancer also. It mediated the pathogenesis for delayed type 4 hypersensitivity reaction and certain autoimmune disorders. So in this class, I am going to discuss about the humoral mediated immunity. It is the production of antibodies, okay, and it involves in four steps. One is the lag phase, where the pathogens are entered into the body and it is its distribution and fate in tissue occurs, and it contacts with the immunocompetent cells. During log phase, the steady rise in the titer of antibody is observed in the body fluid. In the plateau phase, the equilibrium between antibody synthesis occurred, and it is basically a catabolism. And in the decline phase, the catabolism exceeds production and the titer is fall down. The antibody responses can be classified into two classes. One is the primary, another one is secondary response. Basically, the primary response is the antibody response, which is initial antigenic stimulus, and it differs both quantitatively and qualitatively from the secondary one. It is slow, sluggish, and short-lived antibodies production, and the long lag phase can be observed here, where it is basically predominated by the production of IgM. The secondary response is of the antibody production is subsequent to primary response, and it is basically very prompt and powerful and prolonged response. Basically, it is the production of predominantly IgG molecules, which have much higher level antibodies and longer period production. And here we can also found a short and negligible lag phase. So the primary or secondary response can be depicted in the graph, where an antigen is injected into the individual cell and already carrying the specific antibody. There is temporarily fall of antibody level, and it can be combination of antigen growth with the antibody. In this graph, the phases of antibody response is classified. Here, the second, two, and three, four regions are the B and C regions are known as the secondary response, whereas the A to B is the primary response of antibody. During the lag phase, the present persistence of antigen vary with the nature of antigen. Basically, it is takes 2 to 3 weeks for diphtheria toxin, and in case of pneumococcal polysaccharides, within few hours the response antibody response is occurred. And some non-living vaccines also be involved in this case, which is also given for the antibody response generation, and it can be given in multiple doses, and these multiple doses are basically the injection of antigens, and when the first injection of antigen is given, it is known as primary dose, and when the subsequent antigen injection is given, it is known as the booster dose. The vaccination also be carried out with the living vaccine, and it is sufficient for multiplication of organism in the body, which provides the continuous antigenic stimulus. The antigen first enters into the body, and during this antigen, the antigen presenting cells or APCs are activated these APCs are classified into two classes. One is macrophages and another one is dendritic cells. Basically, in this time, the APC bind with the major histocompatibility complex or MHC2. And these MHC2s are basically the immature T cell receptor, which are present in the T cells and which binds either earlier formed complex with the help of T cell receptor. And the whole complex produces signal for activation of CD4 types of cells, and this activation basically induces the maturation of T helper cells. And these T helper cells ultimately forms the interleukin 2, 4, 5, 6 and the B cell production. And these interleukins are essential for the B cells maturation and subsequently release of plasma cells. And these plasma cells are the production house of antibodies. And also there are some plasma cells which act as the memory cells for the antibody responses. Basically, the bone marrow consisting stem cells, which are the precursor of T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes, and the precursor of B lymphocytes, basically thymus independent region, and they grow in the thymus independent region like tonsils, intestine, appendix, lymph, and lymph node, etc. This region. And they are immunogenetically component B lymphocytes, which have the ultimately matured into the secondary B lymphocytes and the plasma cells. And the plasma cells contains the antibody, which is the production house of antibodies. And when the antigen is present, these antibodies are generated from the plasma cells and secreted into the humoral system of multicellular organism. And basically, they are used for the phagocytosis process, which is basically related to the macrophages. So this is the antibody production, where the antigen comes and presented by the APC, and these antigens are processed further with the MHC class 2 molecules, and these MHC class 2 molecules helps the T helper cells for the production of interleukins. And these interleukins are recognized by helper T cells for the production of antibody producing cells known as B cells or plasma cells. Basically, this is the this is further depicted in a simplified picture. This is the helper T cells, which have the MHC class 2 molecule, and it is recognized by the B cells, and from the B cells the plasma cells are generated, which basically secrete the antibodies. There is a continued production of antibody by the cloning of plasma cells, and it is known as the polyclonal antibodies. Basically, the antigen receptors are basically there are a variety of B cells which are undergo cell proliferation, and the clones of the plasma cells and memory cells are produced, and these cells are basically used for the production of polyclonal antibodies, which is secreted into the circulation of humoral system of multicellular organisms. And there are also monoclonal antibody, which is first discovered by Kohler and Milstein. And this is the single antibody forming cell, and the clones produce antibody which have the similar origin. And thus these antibodies are not usually polyclonal, and these monoclonal antibodies can recognize by the same kind of epitopes of the antigen. The monoclonal antibodies are prepared by fusing the immortal myeloma cells with the spleen cells of B cells, and this is derived from a mouse that is been immunized with the indented and intended antigen to produce the monoclonal antibody producing cells. This is known as the hybridoma, because hybridoma is the hybrid between myeloma and B cells. The hybridoma have the characteristics of both cells, that is the production of, it can produce antibodies, and also it can reproduce infinitely. So the monoclonal antibody can be used for the detection of small amounts of drugs, toxins or hormones, and these monoclonal antibodies are basically, the examples are gonadotropin, human chorionic gonadotropin or HCG, which can be used for the pregnancy test, and it is also used for the ELISA test for the AIDS detection. They are treated as the viral disease. They are used for the treatment of viral disease and the detection of immunotherapy of cancer cells. And it can be classified the strains of single pathogen, as for example, the Neisseria gonorrhoeae can be identified, the strains of Neisseria gonorrhoeae can be classified with the monoclonal antibody. So basically, the antibody production is affected by the genetic factor, age, nutritional status, route of administration, size and number of dose, the multiple antigens, adjuvants, immune-responsive agents, and effect, and the also the another effect of the another antibodies. So these are further discussed here. Basically, the difference in immune response to same antigen by different individual, this can be, we generally observe this type of genetic factor. The same type of antigen can be response to differentially with the different organisms. The age is another factor. The embryo, which is immunologically immature, is that derives the immunity from maternal antibodies, and the neonate stage of development also we can found different types of antibody throughout the developmental stages of multicellular organisms. The nutritional status also the factor. It is basically we can found the decreased antibody synthesis when we found the malnutrition and amino acid and vitamin deficiency. The route of administration is also the factor. We can found the parenteral administration of antigen, which is the better immune response. Basically, the route of administration is also influenced the type of antibody production. We can found the oral and nasal pathway is the production house of the IgA. The nasal tract is the production house of IgE, and parentally the IgG is transferred from mother to fetus. The antibody production is also dose dependent. It is effective only above minimum critical dose. If we apply minimum antigen, then the antibody production hampers. It can be further increased by the enhanced intensity of the antibody responses, and beyond a certain level, it inhibits the induce the tolerance of immunological paralysis, and it is known as the immunological paralysis. And it is also increased by the secondary stimulus, but after certain stages, and not further increase occurs. And it is also known as the anamnestic reaction, which is the antigenic reaction to a heterologous antibody production that the host has produced earlier. The adjuvants and substances which enhances the immunogenicity of an antigen, and it increases with the concentration and persistence of circulating antibodies. There are different types of adjuvants. These are inorganic compounds, mineral oil, bacterial products, and these are all used for the enhancing of the antigens, of the antibodies, and it also enhances the immune response to the antigen in different ways also. The immunosuppressive agents are another factor. It inhibits the immune responses. basically it is essential to prevent the graft rejection in transplantation. The x-ray corticosteroids, anti-metabolites, cytotoxic chemicals, anti-lymphocytic serum and radio mimetic drugs are all the immunosuppressive agent which are used for the suppression of immune responses. There are also multiple antigens. When two or more antigens are given simultaneously, the effect may vary. Sometimes there is no effect, and sometimes the effect can be enhanced or effect can be also diminished when the different types of antigens are injected simultaneously. The another antibody also affected the production of antibody. Basically, the immune response gets suppressed by the passive administration of homologous antibodies, and it is known as the feedback mechanism. The negative Rh factor which having by the mother, and the mother having negative Rh factor and fetus having Rh positive, it is the early sensitization by administration of anti-Rh globulin, and the clotting of fetal blood can be occurred by this type of antigen-antibody reaction. There are some molecules known as super antigens. These are the certain proteins which activate large amount of T cells and irrespectively of antigenic specificity. As for example, Staphylococcus enterotoxin, these are basically stimulated only a few T cells, this is known as exaggerated T cell activation, and this is basically used for the production of T cell cytokines, and production of T cell cytokines basically dysfunction, multiple system dysfunction occurs. The disease is known as Staphylococcus shock syndrome. And there are some another type of antigens. These are known as mitogens. This is the chemical. These are the chemicals, substance that encourages the cell to commence the cell division. There are two types of mitogens. Those are known as B cell mitogen and T cell mitogen. Basically, they are the product. They are the agent for the production of T cell and B cells in vivo condition. So, students, in this class, I have discussed about the humoral immunity. Please go through this slide, and if you have any question, you can ask me later. In the next class, I will discuss about the cell-mediated immune response. Thank you.